every day is a getaway. When all of it goes unsaid, I got a holiday, a paid holiday. I got a holiday in my head. And what you want, what you really need, are two different things. What you say?
We just realised that we're not doing a lot of vlogging this holiday, but one thing people might be interested in is the villa we've got. So I'm going to show you around the downstairs before we go up. We've got a garage in here, funnily enough. Amazingly, it's got a games room, everything you would need, chairs, $5 charge for lining. Lots of stuff here that the owners have. Foosball table, although Bob Boucher'd say foosball's different. Air hockey table, and a full size, pretty much. Snooker table, so lots in here, games. The owners do state this is their home and they rent it out, but obviously rent it out through TUI because this is who we travelled with and it's part of our TUI package. It was allocated on arrival. We did ask for a 2 or 3 bedroom because there's only two of us. But the allocated this one, I believe this one's either 5 or 6, but we'll find that out as we go around. So the enter here, we've got a dining area, seating area, television, mirror. The door's just got one lock on it. That other lock didn't really work. It was a lockbox kind of padlock that was attached to the front door handle. The code was supplied by the management company Titan. Far better than Virgin was the fact that we are able to pay the $75 waiver fee before we arrived. Previously with Virgin, I don't know if it's the case, but in 2019 we came with Virgin and we had to go and spend the morning at Contempo's headquarters to go and pay and get a paper receipt for our money. This was all done online well before the time, just got it all sorted so much easier. So Virgin has altered that, but this seems to be far easier. So this is the first bedroom downstairs. As you see, double bed, TV and stand, walk-in wardrobe, and we also have in here, as Elizabeth would tell you, is a necessary room. Got a bath, etc. on there. This is the only bedroom downstairs, but it makes it almost like a self-contained area. Over here, got a lazy boy, two-seater, three-seater in front of a TV. Lights and a nice big clock, fans in the ceiling pretty much everywhere. The pool area is lovely. It's going to test my ability to get out of a patio door, but here we go. Pool's wonderful. No spa with it, but it doesn't need it at all. Lots of furniture. Lots of bits that people have left over the time. It's got its own net. It is apparently cleaned probably once a week or once a fortnight. We haven't seen the cleaners, so I can't say that's the case. It looks fairly clean though without. It runs automatically, I think, from 8 well 4 or 8 well 5, the motors and the heaters, etc. It cuts off automatically. Really good. Obviously, it's lovely. You can argue it's open at the back, but there again, if you go to a water park, you're going to be walking around in your bikini or your shorts or whatever. So people who say you don't like a pool overlooked, you know, it's no more overlooked, in fact, it's less overlooked than your beach or a water park, so kind of for us, get over it. Close this up. Hey, there's this down there, so I'm going to close the long eye door and then that door, which is like locks up. Okay. So this is downstairs, which we've already seen. We'll move over to the kitchen. This was doing on Instagram. We've got a pantry door with a few little bits in there. Big double fridge freezer, microwave oven. I won't go into every door behind you, but there are so many glasses and mugs, plates, cooking utensils, you name it. Everything here is provided. Can't fault anything from that point of view. Everything you would need is here. It all is in working order. And down to the dishwasher, etc. So everything's good. Can't fault that in the slightest. It's a really well maintained and well addressed villa. We'll leave Elizabeth down here while we check a step upstairs. That door, by the way, is locked. It's not a lift or anything. It's the owner's stuff, obviously, behind there. So we've got a split level, which is quite a novelty in the States, because a lot of them are obviously on large single plots. Up here we've got a moving out area, which has got a massive TV screen. As you can see, we've got seating all the way around. It does have surround sound, cinema sound as well, as well as the little speakers. So it's a lovely place. I'll comment about the TV and stuff in a bit. That is, for me, a downer. There's a strange little thing under here. USB port there. And underneath is some weird gadgetry under there. So we have boiler, etc. Aircon unit, big one. Then we've got washer and dryer, which are going at the moment. We've got a kid's bedroom that can sleep, well, two, three, four, even four, I suppose. Next one there. They've got their own walk-in wardrobe as well. Just here we have like a shared bathroom for this area. Family bathroom, because in here is then a third bedroom. Again, it's double with a walk-in wardrobe. Everyone's got a TV, all flat screens, new, modern, etc. And then through here there's almost like another self-contained area, because you can close that door off and be separate. And in here you've got a bit of storage, you've got its own bathroom. We've not even been in here and used it. Flat screen TV, double bed, walk-in wardrobe. So this is bedroom number four. And then as we go back through to the where this area is, and past the shed, in there is our room, our bedroom, which is a massive double. I'll give you a very, very quick scan through. It has its own toilet, its own walk-in wardrobe, massive, and that again is all self-contained. Now, the outside is obviously the room for parking the car, and the street itself is really quite quiet, which is good. I'm just going to spin you around and talk to you. Good bits about this is it's a lovely massive villa. It's got five bedrooms. We wanted two or three, but it didn't matter. Allocating arrivals, sometimes you get lucky, and we did. It's very well appointed, great location. We're just off the 27, south of the 192 junction, so going towards Davenport. As we said, down the road you've got Applebee's, a few other restaurants down, and then you can also get onto the 4 down there and head to Tampa. If you go up, you hit the 192, all the restaurants that are down the 192. Go further up, there's Kagan's Crossing, where there's a big Walmart. We've got a Publix just down the road as well. So it's, you know, decent area, lots of things going on. Negatives. For me, it's TV. They have, I think they bought either a bunch of TVs that are but like we would call Sky Glass, they're kind of locked up. They're called for a company called Roku, and Roku are a channel that are offering streaming services. So there's a massive amount of channels, but it's all stream. For me, the TV is a big negative, simply because I can't see normal US TV. I really don't want to watch Midsummer Murders. There's enough to watch, but it's not that great. And a lot of the local news channels have a lot of pre-recorded stuff on there. This was recorded previously, etc. It says on the bottom, so it's not necessarily live news. So there's a lot of good stuff going on, but that is the only negative. I'm probably being a bit harsh. I would certainly come and stay here again. It's certainly a lovely villa in a great area. For me, spot on. Hope you've enjoyed the tour around. Obviously, we're welcome for you to like, comment, and if you've got any questions, we'll let you ask away. We can tell you some more that's not been included. And yeah, thanks for watching and sticking around. Bye-bye.